Good morning. It's wonderful to be with you all. Thank you all so much for joining us. I'm here, and you'll see shortly, joined by Secretary of State Antony Blinken, and also President Bazoum and President Talon, our dear partners from Niger and Benin. And thank you all so much for joining us today. I'm just thrilled to be here at the U.S.-Africa Leaders Summit, working alongside leaders from both sides of the Atlantic as we work together to strengthen partnerships between the United States and all of our dear friends on the continent of Africa. And that is what this summit is all about, to refresh, to recommit, and to strengthen our partnerships, to pursue opportunities, and to solve the complex, integrated challenges that lie ahead of us together. Opportunities such as increasing trade and connecting markets and moving goods across borders, and challenges such as security, governance, and political reform. We are here today because MCC has and always will listen to our partners on the continent. Our partners want regional integration for trade, for economic growth, to increase the flow of goods across borders, and to create more economic opportunities for their citizens. In 2018, MCC, my agency, sought an additional authority, and it's a special authority, and it's an authority that allows us to enter into regional compacts, and that is exactly what our partners were asking. This authority is complex, and it involves working with several countries at a time. And today, we are deeply honored to be working with two of our critical partners, Benin and Niger. And today marks a historical first, because today we will be signing our first regional compact under this very important authority. The compact will involve $504 million and will be further supported by contributions of $15 million each from Benin and Niger. In entering into this regional compact, MCC will be building on the long-standing relationships that we've already had with both countries, which involve some $1.1 billion of investment in critical sectors such as agriculture, irrigation, and energy. The Benin-Niger Regional Compact will strengthen regional economic collaboration and advance the goals of the African Continental Free Trade Area. By rehabilitating one of the most heavily traveled corridors in West Africa, the compact will give a big boost to the people and the businesses whose livelihoods and futures depend on the flow of goods between Niamey and Cotonou as an economic lifeline. All told, the compact is expected to benefit at least 1.2 million people on both sides of the border. And it could benefit even more people if you, our friends in the business community, joined us as partners to extend the network and further its impact. The United States is so proud to partner with both Benin and Niger. I want to thank the staff at MCC and our dear counterparts in Benin and Niger for their tremendous work in reaching this historic moment. I look forward to working with all of you to ensure that this investment delivers on its enormous potential to give the people of Benin and Niger the tools they need to build a more prosperous future. Thank you so much for joining us, and I'm so excited to be with you all today on what is a very historic day. But first, it is my distinct honor to introduce my dear friend and the U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken, to the stage to share his remarks with you. Secretary of State Blinken.
Good morning, everyone. You've heard from CEO Albright about what is truly an innovative initiative, and I want to say a few words about it this morning. But before I do, Alice, to you, thank you. Thank you for your extraordinary leadership of the MCC. This is, in so many ways, for us around the world, where the rubber meets the road, in actually having concrete projects that are making a concrete difference in the lives of millions of people. And I could not be more proud and enthusiastic about the work that MCC is doing under your leadership. Alice, thank you. President Talon, President Bazoum, we are thrilled to launch this new partnership with you today. As Alice said, this is unprecedented for the MCC, a historic step for our relationship with two important partners. Today, we're signing joint MCC compacts with Benin and Niger. The first time, as you've heard from Alice, that the two countries will collaborate with the MCC to tackle an issue that reaches across their borders. Benin and Niger are two of the fastest growing economies in sub-Saharan Africa. Their partnership will support growth, it'll strengthen trade and transportation infrastructure that connect their nations, their industries, and their people. And as many of you know, one of the tremendous opportunities in Africa, but that extends beyond Africa, is building connectivity within Africa. As we've seen over the years, Africa has more trade with countries outside of Africa than it does within Africa itself. That's not normal. This connectivity will help change that. As this group knows well, the port in Benin is critical to the economy of West Africa, the Cotutuno port. For Benin, it's a major source of revenue, facilitating international trade, allowing the export of its products. For neighboring countries like Niger, this port is the main gateway for exporting goods to markets around the world, as well as for importing vital products, including food and cooking oil. The corridors that allow products to move between Niger and Benin, these form a critical foundation for business and also for livelihoods. The MCC compacts will invest more than $500 million in that infrastructure, and they'll do it with grants, which means that they won't saddle governments with debt. The projects will bear the hallmarks of America's partnership. They'll be transparent. They'll be high quality. They'll be accountable to the people that they mean to serve. And they'll also support good governance. When completed, these projects will make it faster and safer to transport goods along roads and across borders. And they'll connect Benin and Niger to bigger markets and greater opportunities. These are developments that, in turn, can help economies grow sustainably and equitably and deliver meaningful pathways to prosperity for hundreds of thousands, if not more, people. At this week's U.S.-Africa Leaders Summit, we've made it a priority to mobilize these kinds of investments because we know that this is how you create real, tangible benefits for people on both sides of the Atlantic. We're pursuing these investments together, alongside African nations, as genuine partners. That's the foundation of our administration's strategy for the region. And it's also a core pillar of the MCC model. These new compacts were designed by Benin and Niger, thanks to the efforts of President Talon, President Bazoum, partners across their governments and societies. They're funded in part, as you've heard, by these countries. The implementation will be led by them as well. That's the best way to combine our strengths, to maximize our resources, to reach our shared goals. In short, to create real change, we need real partnerships, just like the one we're announcing and signing today. So I wanted to come simply to say congratulations to everyone involved. This is a milestone. This is innovation. I think it points the way forward as well for many of the projects that MCC will undertake, and it certainly points the way forward for Africa and for our friends in Benin and Niger. To everyone here, thank you for joining this morning, and thank you for your own engagement. The opportunity is immense. We're trying to put in place the means, the methods by which to actually seize it. Thank you very much.
Your Excellencies, honored guests, please welcome Patrice Talon, President of the Republic of Benin.
Chers participants,
dear participants,
le, Madame la directrice
de MCC.
Madame,
Monsieur le
Head of MCC, Mr. Secretary of State. It's a real pleasure for me to be the beneficiary and the
actor
in this regional compact, which gives more dynamic to the cooperation between the United States and Africa. It's a major innovation that we see in international cooperation and in cooperation between the U.S. and Benin and our
Comme a dit tout à l'heure le secrétaire d'État, c'est une innovation à remarquer parce qu'elle aide à la connectivité entre deux pays voisins, le Niger et le Bénin,
bring together two neighboring
pour rendre cet espace plus attractif pour le business. Vous savez, l'Afrique est très grande,
you know,
mais certains des pays constituent des marchés assez petits
et le
business. L'attractivité de nos pays, donc dans un tel contexte, parfois est faible. En améliorant la connectivité entre les pays d'Afrique, notamment ceux dont les marchés sont petits, c'est une belle façon d'augmenter l'attractivité de ces zones-là. Et c'est en cela que le compact régional qui va être signé tout à l'heure, qui a été conclu, est une innovation majeure. Je voudrais inviter ou prier le MCC, notamment sa directrice générale, les autorités américaines, de persévérer dans cette voie-là et que bientôt nous puissions initier des compacts qui seront orientés vers la promotion d'investissements américains privés dans nos pays. Ce qu'on constate malgré tous les efforts que les pays font pour améliorer le climat des affaires, que le nombre d'investisseurs américains privés est faible sur le continent. Le compact peut être un instrument, tel que nous venons de l'observer, pour améliorer l'attractivité. Le compact peut être un instrument pour promouvoir l'investissement privé dans nos pays. Parce que le développement ne peut pas venir durablement rien qu'avec les investissements dans les infrastructures, avec les investissements dans tout ce qui concerne les bases pour le développement. Mais pour qu'il soit réel, il faut effectivement que les investissements privés viennent sur ce continent. C'est le seul moyen de créer un développement réel durable. Je voudrais donc finir par ce message-là. L'attractivité de l'Afrique doit être un élément dans le rapport entre les États-Unis et chacun de nos pays pour que le privé prenne le relais des efforts que font les uns et les autres dans la promotion de l'économie africaine. Merci. Merci aux autorités américaines pour cela.
Merci. Your Excellencies, honored guests, please welcome Mohamed Bazoum, President of the Republic of Niger.
Monsieur le Président Patrice Talon, Président du Bénin, chers amis, chers frères,
Monsieur le Secrétaire d'État Blinken,
Madame Alice Albright,
CEO de Madame Alice Albright,
Compact Millennium Challenge,
MCC,
Mesdames et Messieurs, je voudrais à mon tour dire ma joie
to say how happy I am to participate in this signature in a few moments,
the signature which launches this regional compact
between Niger and Benin.
Le Bénin,
Benin
est un partenaire stratégique
is a
pour le développement du Niger parce que le port
of Niger
de Cotonou
port of
est le port le plus proche de Niamey.
Port
il se situe à 1000
kilomètres.
Et nous avons depuis longtemps considéré que c'est notre port naturel
et
nous avons développé tous les instruments nécessaires pour que nous ayons une relation qui rende viable
l'économie du Niger en se basant sur ce corridor que nous lie au Bénin.
By linking, nos amis américains ont compris cela
en faisant en sorte que nous disposions d'infrastructures de qualité entre nos deux pays. Nous sommes sur la fin du pacte nigérien qui a investi énormément déjà dans les infrastructures routières sur cet axe Bénin-Niger. Ce compact régional va venir consolider ce qui a été déjà fait. C'est exactement les vœux que nous pourrions exprimer qui sont pris en charge dans le cadre de ce projet. Je voudrais à cet égard rendre hommage à la coopération américaine avec le Niger et la coopération américaine avec nos deux pays, le Niger et le Bénin. Il y aura en plus des investissements dans les infrastructures, des réformes institutionnelles qui vont être mises en œuvre et qui faciliteront singulièrement la fluidité du commerce et de l'interaction entre nos deux pays. Le gouvernement américain, en procédant de la sorte, va au-devant de nos voeux, va au-devant de notre volonté, et c'est une raison supplémentaire pour nous de considérer que nous avons affaire à un partenaire attentif à nos attentes et qui fait les choses conformément à ce que nous ne pouvons passer au mieux de nos intérêts. Voilà pourquoi, Madame, je voudrais vous remercier et vous dire notre engagement à faire en sorte que les infrastructures ainsi que les réformes qui vont être mises en œuvre soient exploitées de la façon optimale possible pour que nous renforcions les relations entre le Bénin et le Niger. Merci beaucoup.
Between Bénin and Niger. Thank you very much.